Hey you, my name is Thomas Tomscar Ridgewell.
I'm Elliot Goff.
And I'm Eddie Bowley.
And welcome back to
Content!
It's a show.
Is it?
Can't prove that. No evidence.
Well, boys, here we are. Except we're not here. We are all in separate places because of COVID-19.
No, not. I can touch you. Look.
You cannot touch me. Get off. Ooh. Oh, Dad. Ooh. Not again. I've just spent the past few hours, because I've got nothing else to do, researching memes. And I've also been working with the lovely people that have been keeping me company on my very lo-fi Twitch streams to come up with a pretty hefty quiz all about those memes. So, boys, are you ready to play So You Think You Can Meme?
I think I can meme.
Yes, queen.
What are your team names? Your teams now.
Elliot.
Your team is Elliot.
Yes.
Eddie, what's your team name?
I'll go with Team Not Elliot.
I like that a lot.
Either way, I feel a bit of pride if I win or lose.
Your self-esteem is that low that just any mention is worthy.
If you'd like to play this game along at home, feel free to just scream answers at your monitor, and if you get it right, give yourself a point. If you get it wrong, though, throw yourself down the stairs. All right, boys, for this first round, we're going to be going over some meme facts.
Max.
I'm going to ask y'all some questions, and you've got to tell me which is the answer to the question. That's how a quiz works. Elliot.
Yes.
First question for you.
Me.
In 2015, a video of the appropriately named Ethan Brown went viral, featuring him covered head to toe in peanut butter. But in what year was the video originally filmed? Was it 2004, 2013, 1999 or 2007?
1999.
Elliot, you've made a fool of yourself. I'm going to hand this over to Eddie if you'd like to try and steal the point.
No!
2007, 2013 or 2009. In which case, I'll go with 2003.
That was not an option.
2004.
A point for Eddie Bowley. Yes, the peanut butter baby is now probably about 16 or so years old. And I don't like that. Right, Eddie.
Yes.
Pepe, an expressive and highly emotive frog who somehow became an icon for the alt-right, originates from which webcomic? Control-Alt-Delete, Eat My Paint, The Perry Bible Fellowship, or Boys Club?
Boys Club.
You are correct. It is Boys Club.
Yeah.
Elliot Goff.
That's me.
Another famous amphibian, Kermit the Frog, is well known for sipping tea and dishing out hot takes. But exactly what tea has he been known to drink? Green tea, PG Tibbs, Twinings, or Lipton's?
Lipton's!
A point for you, Elliot Goff, and nothing for Gretchen Wieners. Eddie Bowley.
Yes.
Who is the Zodiac Killer? Is it Ted Bundy, Tom Cruise, Ted Cruz, or Jeb Bush?
Ted Cruz is the meme, but I suspect the actual killer was Ted Bundy.
No, you are wrong. It is definitely Ted Cruz. Everyone knows this, and you've let him get away.
Hey, why didn't I get a chance?
Because... Elliot, what do you think the answer is?
I think it's Ted Cruz.
You are correct and you get the point.
Wow.
Wow, a point for Elliot. Well earned. I am new at this, okay? Elliot, the cryptid Slenderman entered our realm in 2009 and has gone on to inspire horror movies and even an attempted murder. But where exactly did he come from? Was it Creepypasta, Something Awful, Marble Hornets, or Lonely Girl 15?
That is actually quite interesting, because I'm actually between two there, but I'm not sure where it originally came from. I'm going to guess that it came from Marble Hornets.
What was your other guess?
My other guess would be Creepypasta.
I can tell you that you are wrong.
Okay.
Eddie.
Creepypasta.
You are also incorrect. The correct answer was Something Awful, the forums. It was part of a Photoshop competition, and someone created the character in the background of an image. And then the world went mad.
Oh.
Eddie, while the internet may appear to be a lawless, chaotic place, it is allegedly bound by certain unbreakable rules. What is the second rule of the internet? Thou shalt not take the Lord's name in vain. If it exists, there is porn of it. We do not forgive, we do not forget. You do not talk about B.
It is the fourth option. We do not talk about B.
You are correct. However, you have now talked about B and you're going to 4chan jail, also known as the real world, because if you're not at 4chan, you're doing great.
Yay!
I'm very proud of you. You have a nice fat cock.
Oh, is that my prize?
Yeah!
A nice plump chicken.
Elliot Goff.
Yes.
What was it that user Titanium Gecko posted in 2005 that was shortened into the initialism NEDM? Did it stand for Never Ever Date Men, Not Even Doom Music, No Emos Drink Milk, or no energy, didn't masturbate.
The second one.
You are indeed correct.
I don't have any context for this. I've just heard that phrase before.
In 2005, a video was posted of a cat, I believe, getting burnt alive, and the user put doom music alongside it. And another person, Titanium Gecko, basically said that not even doom music can justify such brutality. Eddie.
Yes.
Wait. What song is this? Is it We Are Number One? Is it All Star? Is it Sandstorm? Or is it Brody Quest?
Is it We Are Number One?
It is not. Elliot.
Sandstorm?
You are correct. It is. And it goes like this. Elliot.
It's me.
Two Girls, One Cup was a controversial 1 minute video that featured two young women eating and vomiting poop into each other's mouths. But don't worry, it was only a trailer for an hour-long porno titled what? Hungry Bitches? Two Girls, One Cup? Shit Sisters? Or Eating for Two?
I like all of those options. I want to go with Hungry Bitches.
You are correct.
I like that. I like that they have a sense of humor.
I believe it was Brazilian, and I can't remember. Either the creator went to jail.
Oh.
Or had to pay like a $100,000 fine for creating such filth. All right, Eddie.
Yes.
Rage comics and reaction images serve as some of the earliest and most recognizable memes on the internet, many of which are traced from the faces of celebrities. But which of these celebrities has not been traced into a reaction meme? Is it Neil deGrasse Tyson, Jackie Chan, Chuck Norris, or Nicolas Cage?
Chuck Norris.
You are very correct. Good job, Eddie.
Good job, Eddie.
Yeah.
You have Neil deGrasse Tyson, watch out, we got a badass over here. You have Nicolas Cage's You Don't Say, and you have Jackie Chan's My Brain Is Full of Fuck.
Eddie, that's offensive.
I can tell you so far that Elliot is winning with 5 points and Eddie is trailing behind with 4.
Ooh.
We all love memes. And you know, we love memes. All right, fellas, one of the strongest points of memes is how quotable they are. And today we're going to test your meme literacy with whether or not you can finish the quote. So you can buzz in when you think you have the answer. Elliot, your sound is this. And Eddie, your sound is this. Finish that quote. None pizza.
Left beef!
You are correct. Way to go, little buddy. None pizza left beef is a 2007 meme in which someone ordered a custom Domino's pizza with nothing on it except for beef on the left-hand side. Ah, oh, fuck.
I can't believe you've done this.
You are correct. Unfortunately, we will never know what Pee-wee 28 was going to say as he was so brutally assaulted. It is Wednesday.
My dudes!
Very good. Fun fact, the original version of it is actually an image of a frog on Tumblr. The Vine is merely appropriating his assertion that it is indeed Wednesday. I like singing. I like dancing.
I like trains.
Very good. One of my own in there because I'm a narcissist. Fun fact, it was originally going to be I like dinosaurs, but I decided suicide by train was funnier. Somebody touch her.
My spaghetti.
A point for Eddie Bowley. Eddie, for a bonus point, can you guess the year of which this meme originated?
It's because it's in kind of Technicolor. I'm assuming it's like 50s to 60s. I'll go with 58.
The correct answer was 1939.
I was off by a bit.
Just a tad. All right, here's a question that, Elliot, you're going to have to try your absolute hardest to beat Eddie on, as it is as old as him. All your base.
I belong to us.
Yay! Very good. Fun fact, that meme is from a poorly translated 1989 Japanese game, Zero Wing. Let's pivot from the distant past to the relatively recent present. So there I was.
Barbecue sauce on my titties?
That is a point for you, Elliot. For a bonus point, where does this meme originate? And I don't mean where was it popularized, but where does it originate?
I'm gonna go YouTube?
The answer is, it is a quote from Orange is the New Black, Season 1, Episode 5, that was quoted in a Vine. I didn't know that until researching this video, so. I play Pokemon Go.
Every day!
Ooh, I'm gonna give you half a point for that, as the correct quote is Everwee Day.
Sure!
That is a song perfectly encapsulating the popularity of Pokemon Go from Misha from the Czech Republic. He's still making songs. He just released a song about the coronavirus. And you know what? It ain't half bad. Roadwork ahead.
Yeah, I sure hope it does.
That's a point for you, Eddie Bowley. Fun fact about this video, it is funny. Final quote to finish, boys. Two bros chilling in a hot tub.
5 feet apart because they're not gay?
I'll allow it. It is 5 feet apart because they're not gay. A bonus point if you can tell me who created that vine?
Anthony Padilla from Smosh.
Well, hey, I'm impressed. I didn't know that. That is 2 points for Elliot.
Huh?
I know. All right, so the scores as they are is Elliot is in the lead with 11 and a half points, Eddie trailing tragically behind with just 7.
Fuck.
I know. I'm honestly a little disappointed. I don't think I can love you anymore. Get your phones out because it's time to attach a quote to that meme. Elliot.
Yes.
Give me the quote that associates with this meme.
Guess I'll die.
That's a point for you, Elliot, you handsome little boy. Fun fact about this is a photograph of Mike Baldwin taken in 2009. So he likely has died.
What a fun fact.
Thank you. I worked pretty hard on it. Eddie.
Yes.
What's this meme trying to say?
Ah, shit. Here we go again.
There we go. That's a point for Eddie, the handsomest Eddie I've ever known. All right, Elliot, we're going to ramp up the difficulty a little bit.
Hit me with it. Hit me with your best shot.
What's this meme say to you?
Stonks. No, that's a different one. No, I know what it is.
Elliot, you know what? I will give you one more chance.
Oh, come on.
I will not. Just because Eddie's so sad. Eddie, what's this quote say?
It's free real estate.
You are very correct. For a bonus point, who is it free real estate for?
It's like a sketch from the Tim and Eric show, and it's like they're giving away free houses or something. I can't remember who to.
They're giving away one free house only to one person.
No, I don't know.
It is, you have to be called Jim Booney to get the free real estate. Eddie, what's this meme?
Why the fuck you lying?
That's a good point for Eddie. Fun fact about this meme, it is using the instrumentals of Too Close by the R&B group Next. Elliot.
Yep.
Was a meme?
He's not just saying aliens, is he?
He is saying aliens. That is the quote. The quote is aliens. That is, I believe, Giorgio or Giorgio from the show Ancient Aliens, in which he explains that everything was aliens. Eddie.
Yes.
Give me some words.
Oh my god, they were roommates.
That's the point for Eddie. And you sounded like him. That was good. Fun fact about this meme, allegedly, the woman in the video came forward and said that the conversation was indeed about two roommates that turned into gay lovers. Elliot.
Yep.
Here's a meme.
Oh no.
Is this the round where Eddie takes the lead back? Let's find out.
Have you got a grip?
I'm not gonna give you that, Eddie.
Hey! You got any grapes?
That's a point for Eddie. Have you got a grape was nice, but not what I was looking for. Fun fact about the duck song, it has never officially gone gold or platinum, despite having over 400 million views on YouTube, and I can only imagine how many copies it has sold. So logically, it's outperformed the Muffin song a billionfold. That's an exaggeration, but at least 4 times. Eddie.
Yes.
What a meme.
Oh, really?
How do you spell it?
Oh. R-L-Y.
Very good. That is a point for Eddie. The Oh Really Owl has devastatingly been made obsolete by the far inferior quoting of just saying, ah, that happened. Elliot.
That's me.
Where's the meme?
What part of it?
The best part.
Disgusting.
You are correct. Disgusting is indeed what I was looking for. For a bonus point, Elliot, which one of them did the shit?
Oh, the little sister.
That is good. The 2 points for Elliot.
She made a little video coming out, being like, no, I did the shit.
She did. She proudly admitted having done the shit.
It was me that done the shit.
Eddie?
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe.
Then Perish.
Very good. Point for Eddie. For a bonus point, who is perishing?
I don't know. Oh.
The correct answer was a furry, as this is part of a text roleplay conversation between someone oo-wooing and Mr. Obama.
Oh, that's nice.
Let me just tally up these scores here. The scores as they stand are Elliot is still just in the lead with 15 and a half points. Eddie just trailing behind with 14. He is catching up, Elliot. You should be afraid.
I'm always afraid of Eddie catching me.
Why? All right, boys, I'm about to show you an image of a meme, only the silhouette of that meme, however. You have to tell me what that meme is. First to buzz in gets the meme. Y'all ready, boys?
Sure.
I am ready to buzz.
Elliot, you came through first.
Oh, shit, what up? It's that boy.
It is that boy, Elliot. I'm so proud of you. Elliot, for a bonus point, where is one of the first places that boy was ever found?
Oh, wow. Reddit?
Nope, it was an AP physics textbook.
What were they trying to teach?
I actually have no idea what he was doing in that book. Here's a fucking meme.
It's Fat Bugs Bunny, but I don't know what the meme is.
I'm looking for the meme's real name.
Yeah, that's the issue. I know what it is. I just Blanking on the meme.
I'm afraid to say that if you buzz in and get the answer wrong, I will deduct a point.
Whoa, ooh. that wasn't added. That wasn't added
I'm sorry, but I have to stop you from hoarding
points. No, you can't add rules later on.
I just did. It's my quiz. I'm looking for the meme's name, my friend.
I don't know. I'm passing.
Unfortunately, the correct answer was Big Chungus. And I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to take a point away from you. All right. Fingers on boobies, my little friends. Here comes a fucking meme.
Trollface!
Trollface is correct. I'm about to throw a hot meme at you. You've got to tell me what it is we're looking at here.
It's the funniest shit I've ever seen. It's Pickle Rick!
I'm afraid to tell you, you are wrong. You are looking not at Pickle Rick, but Larry the Cucumber. Allow me to show you what Pickle Rick actually looked like. And you'll see how much of a fool you have been. Coming up with a fresh new meme, lads. Y'all ready for this? What's that meme?
It's Doge.
It is Doge. You are correct and also quite handsome. What are we looking at here, boys?
It's Long Cat.
Point for Eddie. Very good. It is Long Cat. Where's Long Cat from for an extra point?
I don't know, Finland?
It was Japan, I'm afraid. It's a cat. Where else is it going to be from?
Only in Japan.
All right, boys. Y'all ready for a hot new meme? Who's that?
That's Gizmo!
Ah, oh, you are correct. You successfully saw through the trick question.
The Baby Yoda trick.
That was the old Baby Yoda trick. Who's this?
It's the Velociraptor.
That's a point for Reddy! Last one, everybody. What are we looking at here?
It's Badger, Badger, Badger.
That's a point for Eddie, the ugliest Eddie I've ever met. You both performed equally badly in that round with 2 points each, making the current scores 17.5 points for Elliot and 16 points for Eddie. All right, boys, welcome to Real or Fake Meme, arguably the most high-stakes round in this game. I will be presenting you with either a meme or just the results of a random word generator, and you have to correctly identify if it is a real meme or a fake meme. If you get it correct, you get a point. If you get it wrong, you lose a point. Elliot.
Yes.
Is this a real meme or a word generator? Ceiling cat.
That is a real meme.
You are correct. That is a point for you.
It watches you masturbate.
That is the fun fact I have written down here.
Yeah.
Eddie.
Yes.
Virgin medicine.
That's a fake meme.
You are correct. That is a fake meme. The brutal results of a word generator. Elliot.
Yes.
Is the following a real meme or a fake meme? Craft brag.
Fake meme.
You are correct. Craft brag is just some words. Craft brag could be a valid term from the Pinterest community. I don't know. Eddie.
Yes.
What is your verdict on nonsense sphere?
That is a fake meme.
You are correct, Eddie. That is indeed a fake meme. One could argue that this hellhole of a planet we live on is indeed a nonsense sphere, but not a real meme yet.
Not yet.
Thus far, you've all been doing great. You've all been pegging each other level. However, you know, someone's gonna slip up or else Elliot's got this in the bag. Speaking of, Elliot.
Yes!
Lemon party. Real or fake meme?
That is a real meme.
You are correct, Eddie.
Yes.
Object gun.
That's fake.
You are correct. Object gun is a fake meme. Elliot.
Yes.
Left shark. Real or fake?
That is a real meme.
It is a real meme. In 2015, sharks stood either side of Katy Perry, but for some reason, we don't give a shit about the right one. Eddie.
Mm-hmm.
Freedom frog.
I'm gonna go with fake meme.
You are correct. Devastatingly, the freedom frog is not a real meme. Although, he is the meme we need. Elliot.
Yes.
Blue waffle.
That is also a real meme.
You are correct. That is a real meme. And in the year 2011, a gynecologist determined that it was either a photograph of a mutilated vagina or a photoshopped vagina. Please don't Google it, though. And Eddie.
Yes.
Meat spin.
That's a real meme.
You are correct. Eddie, meat spin is indeed a real meme. I'm so proud of you boys.
Yay, you spin me right round, baby.
Yep, fun fact about this meme, we have all done it.
It is? Yeah, I have, yeah.
Yeah.
On a hot day, it really cools your partner down.
It sure does. Right, so here we are with the final scores. Eddie, you're coming in with a hot, very much legal 21. But Elliot is leading the way with a bold and brazen 23.5. Elliot truly is more than just memes.
Whoa!
Well, guys, I want to say thank you so much for playing my game, of which I've already forgotten the name. How did you do if you were playing along at home? Did you get the memes right, or did you have to throw yourself down the stairs? If you did the latter, I suppose you're not commenting. So for every view this video has but doesn't have a follow-up comment, can only assume those people are sadly no longer with us. Righty-ho, hibbity-bitty-hobbity-hoo. Here's my favorite fan art of the week, and here are the most recent videos. Did you know that contents come out every Tuesday? They do, even in quarantine. So I will see you next Tuesday. Quack.
Quack, 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 quack. I'm a duck.